Hey everybody, welcome to Chris BI. Today we're going to be talking about the most exciting feature I've seen in days. Absolutely days. And that's how you can embed Power BI inside of SharePoint and all the questions I've gotten from people about all this stuff. There is so much to get into here. This is going to be one of the biggest features that Power BI has rolled out, and no one knows how valuable this is until you see it. Wait till you check it out. Let's head over to my desktop in just a second. Is counting on you. Like, subscribe, leave a comment down below, turn on that alarm bell so you don't miss any future mission. All right, so when we get started talking about Power BI embedding inside of SharePoint, a lot of questions still come up. What about licensing? Do we still have to have licenses, all that stuff? Yes, you still have to have licenses. Licenses, all those rules still apply, okay? So if you are in a pro workspace, you need to share it to other pro people, and you know they have pro licenses and they can access it in the Power BI service, hey, great, they can access it through SharePoint. Same thing with PPU or premium. So if you're building in a premium workspace and you share it to other people and they can consume that report, then thumbs up, you're good to go, okay? If those people cannot consume that information in the Power BI service, they're not gonna be able to consume it inside of your SharePoint. So if you're going to try and troubleshoot why someone's not able to access a Power BI report inside of a PowerPoint, go out to the Power BI service and see if they have access to it there, all right? Next, all right, exact same sharing rules apply, right? So again, they have to have access to it inside of Power BI in order for them to see it inside of SharePoint. So that means if they're outside your company or you haven't shared the content to them, they're not going to be able to see it, okay? So all the same stuff applies. So if you know how it worked in Power BI, you know how Power BI works inside of SharePoint, okay? Super easy, real simple, right? Same thing's true of row-level security, object-level security. All of that stuff still applies, right? So if you know you have a whole process for getting access to data and row level security and all that good stuff, follow that process, okay? You're going to be able to still get access to everything, okay? But that's the high level stuff. People are asking, hey, Chris, how the heck do I do it? Super simple, all right? So this is the Power BI plugin that you can get out on the service. And honestly, if you have it, it's just under my add-ins. You get it here. Otherwise, you can go to the Microsoft Store, get it added in. Once you click on add-in, it's going to drop in this little page. And it's really simple. Put in a URL for a report, okay? So really easy. So here's my Power BI report that I want to embed inside of my PowerPoint. I'm going to, actually, you know what I'm going to do? So two ways, right? You can grab this URL and you can stick it in. I'm going to show it to you in just another way to do this. So I'm going to stick this in. I'm going to hit insert. And voila, my report is embedded inside of Power BI. Now, or inside my Power BI report is embedded inside of PowerPoint. Some notes. What do we see here? Right now, we only have the ability to embed the entire report page, okay? So, and that report page does not respect if you have set, you know, the pane to, you know, if your view is set so that you can only see, you know, the width of whatever it is you're working on, right? So if I'm in my Power BI desktop and I go in on my view and I set my page view to fit to width, like this is doing right here, you know, in the Power BI service, it'll look like this and you'll have a full view. In PowerPoint today, you get the whole thing embedded. So I get all this gray spaces. So be aware of that. Okay. So it embeds the entire page. And you're like, but okay, hey, Chris, this is great. And I can interact with this. And wow, this is awesome. I've got my access to my filter pane. So I could, you know, I've got Canada there, but I could go in and I could have something else here, right? Like I could set it up so it's like Central US or whatever, right? Awesome. I can go interact with this. I can explore it. This is really great. But what if I want to have a bunch of different versions of that exact same page, but I want to have it filtered down so I could, like, I can have a page that's dedicated to Canada and I can have a page that's dedicated to the Central US. That's super easy, right? And in fact, that's a great way to do it because you can embed a report page here And then you can add in your own commentary, add in your own narrative to give some understanding and background into what's going on inside of your reports. That's one of the big key things that's out there when it comes to talking about data stories, is curating your experience and honing in and describing and creating a narrative around what's going on inside your organization and what's important there. So you want to see how to do this? Again, we're going to pop over to Power BI service. I'm going to filter down and I'm going to say, you know what? This is filtered to Canada, but I want a link that's not just going to be filtered to my bookmarked link or my personal cache link. So I'm going to go to Central US or right there. So I've got my filter in place. I'm going to go to export. I'm going to go to PowerPoint. I'm going to embed as live data. When I click on this, it's going to ask me if I want a URL that's embed your report with the data filters you selected. You say, yes, copy that guy, right? Now I go back over here and I paste. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this, right? So that we actually have two of them. I'm going to do one with Canada or with the Central US that we just had there. So I'm going to put that in and you're going to visually see that this is Central US. Okay, we can see that there. I'm gonna collapse this. Come on, collapse. I show it. There we go. Okay, so here's my Central US. Now I'm gonna go back over to Power BI. I'm gonna select a different filter. I'm gonna say I want France. All right, so I've got France here. Again, export PowerPoint embed as live data with my embed report filter selected. Hit copy. Pop back over to my PowerPoint, go down to that duplicated page I have. So here's France. Insert. Blah-da! Now I've got my France, you know, my page that's filtered down to France, so I can have a narrative around what's going on inside of France, and I can have a different page that's filtered down to Canada. Now this allows me to create an entire deck of slides and presentations so I can run through all my different regions, I can run through all my different products, I can run through everything under the sun inside of one PowerPoint deck that I can refresh, open up on a regular basis and be like, ready to go. You say, hang on, Chris, that's all well and good, but I don't necessarily want to have my whole page, right? That whole page, look at this, Chris. Look at that page. That's not a great page, right? It's got all these visuals. It's got all this text. This is great for an analyst or in an exploratory fashion where you're trying to frame up everything that's going on inside of a report and you want to understand more about what's happening. But what if I really want to hone in on some data and create just a singular visual? And if you look at the Microsoft documentation, they're like, oh, you can't do a single visual. But aha, 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 aha. Wait till you see this. All right. So that's our next thing. Our next quest is how do we curate and embed not just one, but two visuals inside the exact same experience? So I'm going to show you that too in just 1 second. All right. Again, we pop back over to our experience. We maintain our same filter construct. So we're still on France, right? Now here's where the magic hits. And it hits so good. Ah, go to focus mode. What do we got in focus mode? We have a singular visual, all right? Focused in on one subject area. So all I do is go to export, PowerPoint, embed live data. With that check mark clicked again, hit copy. Go back over to my PowerPoint, hit paste, insert. Ah, there it is. I now have a singular page inside of here that I can use and build out. And now if I want, get out of my way. I can like minimize that little visual. So like, boom, I've got my report. It's right here, right? It's right here. It's so beautiful. Now I can go in and I could talk about, I could have like a pop-up on here that goes in and explains things. So I could really tell a very customized story on here. Well, that's all good, Chris, but like, hey, look, what if I wanted to have like a single KPI that we include as well? Hey, you know me, I got you covered, right? So we do the same thing, right? Same thing we did before, go into focus mode. Focus mode, you're like, this, frankly, Chris, this is garbage right now. Yeah, like, what are you gonna do with that? Ha 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 ha, embed live data, copy, cancel. Go back to report. Go over to paste your URL. Paste it. Insert it. Ooh, boom. Oh, look at that. Look, 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 look. It's all right there. Ah, this is just incredible. Now, I know what you're saying. You're like, hey, Chris, you know what? Oopsies. That didn't work. Can you not copy one of these things? No. Copy. Paste. Oh. Ah. All right. So, now I want to save it as an image. So, I'm going to do the exact same thing that I did before, right? So, I've got my URL. I copy it. I go back over here. And let's say, hey, Chris, I want to share this to people outside my organization, or I want to just have a snapshot of what it looked like last time. So I could always come back and just like explain and understand what it looked, you know, like what was sales like last month, right? Whoopsies, what happened there? That was weird. Simple enough. I can come on now, move, work with me now here, computer. Hello, computer. All right, well, we're not moving. There we go. All right, so I want to have this as a snapshot, or I want, because I want to share it, or to people who don't have access. Ah, ha, ha, ha. There's this wonderful little nubbin right up here. Right up here. You click on this, and you can go and show as a saved image. Now, I am no longer interactive. This becomes static that lives with my PowerPoint, and I'm just, you know, it's just like any other image. I can go on with my life. You say to yourself, this is great, Chris. Now I can, like, share this around, send this to other people. Like, yes, you can. But let's say, okay, so now you've got this image, and, okay, that's all well and good, but now I want to interact with it again. Well, it's an image. I can't interact with it. At least that's what I thought. I thought you couldn't interact with it. But ho, 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 ho. Wait, wait, wait. Now, I go in. I uncheck the show as a saved image. Blah-da, 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 blah-da. Ah, it is now back to live. All right. This is just mind-boggling. I'm super excited about this. But wait. There's one more thing that you can do inside here, and you gotta check this out, all right? This is a bonus slide. We're gonna do this live. I'm gonna show you how you can do this. So I'm just go ahead, and I'm gonna duplicate this page. We're gonna call this one Metrics. Yeah, because this, we're gonna show you some stuff around metrics that you can do inside here that it's just mind-boggling, all right? So here is my report, right? I've got my report all set up here. I can expand it out. I can go and I can look at the different quality metrics I have, right? So I set up a quality metrics out there so I can manage the quality of my data in the service, and I can see it, how it's going, when I have issues or not. I can understand where I've got discrepancies. Heck, look at this. I can even go in and I can create notes, and I can like check in, and I can say, hey, Power BI Luchador. Well, that didn't work very well. The Zoom doesn't work great on it, but I can create a note and say, hey, Power BI Luchador, let's take a look at this thing, right? But you're saying, hey, Chris, this is incredible. Yeah, you're frankly, you're right. This is all done using the Power BI Visual, the metrics visual that I embedded inside of a Power BI tab on my report, right? So it's right on my quality scorecard. I've got a link right into my scorecard right here. Because if I go back out to my report and I go down to my quality scorecard, right, which is right here, I take this guy. I'm like, yeah, I want to embed this inside my Power BI report. I go, okay, hey, great. Grab my URL. I go to add-ins, I click on Microsoft Power BI, I paste in my thing, and oh no, invalid URL, scorecard not supported. Oh, snap. I could totally take care of that though, right? Because I don't need to just go directly to the scorecard. I go to my, I go to the report that I've published, and then I go to that tab that has that scorecard on it. It's right here. I copy this. I go back over to my Power BI reports. I hit insert. Oh, boom. There you go. I now have a scorecard embedded inside of my Power BI, embedded inside of my PowerPoint. But wait, look at this. Not only can I go in and see, not only can I go in and see what's going on in the conversation, like, hey, look, just 2 hours ago, I told the Power BI Luchador, we got to go in and fix this. Well, I can make a new check-in and I can include a note and I could say, hey, man, everything looks good, right? And hit save. Now, anyone who's working in my reports can not only see that there was some commentary or some issues around some of the metrics, but we could see that discourse, that back and forth to show when something's right, when something's not, or whatever's going on. And I'm in PowerPoint here. I'm still in PowerPoint. I could be presenting this, and I could present this out on a YouTube video, or I could present this at a conference. We could do wherever you are. You could have the access to this inside of PowerPoint. Frankly, I was just blown away by this stuff. I hope you got something out of this. I hope you enjoyed this stuff. Like, subscribe, leave a comment down below on how this is going to transform your ability to tell data stories and convey better information to people inside your organization. Thank you guys so very much for tuning in. You guys have a fantastic day. Peace.